Today we will be making snickerdoodles.
Snickerdoodles are a type of molded cookie. So what did we do with our hands, Jade?
Washed them for 20 seconds.
Perfect. And we took out all our equipment and hopefully all our ingredients. This is tape two. Last night we tried to do it. We had quite a few mistakes, so we're going to go with it one more time. All right. So our first ingredient is a half stick of margarine. Mommy made a mistake already.
Butter?
Actually, a half cup of margarine or butter, which is one stick. So we already have that here. In school, we're going to use margarine, but at home, we're going to use butter. Okay, I would always tend to use butter if you have it available because it just gives the cookie a better flavor. We tend to use margarine in school because it is less expensive. So we're just gonna put the butter over there because all we have to really do is open it. Our second ingredient is sugar. So Jake's gonna measure the sugar and he's gonna measure 3/4 cup of sugar. So I'm gonna give him wax paper. I'll help you with that so it doesn't go all over. Okay, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna put that right there and you're going to put this in there 3 times and then you're gonna level it off and I'm gonna give you a piece of wax paper to put it on. You gotta level it off, remember, right? You can level it off here or you can level it off over there.
I want to level it.
Then you're gonna put the measured ingredients back here. Remember, do it nice. Okay, and then while Jake's doing that, you're gonna put that there. I'm gonna crack 1 egg in a custard bowl. So last night, my phone, right, kept running out of storage space. So we did it a few times, and then I had to delete a bunch of different things. So tonight we're hoping what we have to do is do this once. So that's twice. So that's a half cup, but it calls for 3/4 cup. So he's using 1/4 cup 3 times. I've cracked my egg in my custard bowl. And I'm gonna place that right over here too. So let's bring it maybe so they can see. 3 times, perfect, okay? Now we're gonna put this over here. Now we're gonna take, I'm gonna help you and put all the extra stuff back in. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna start sifting the flour because you like to sift flour. I've told Jake he can't keep putting his hands in his mouth and wiping his nose, because that's not really good sanitation. What we're gonna do next is, do you remember what this is called, Jay?
A sifter.
It's a sifter. And what a sifter does is it incorporates air into the flour and makes it fluffier. So with this recipe, it calls for 1 1/4 cups plus 3 tablespoons. What you have to do is sift a bunch of flour first, and then we're going to lightly spoon and measure. So I'm gonna put a bunch of flour through and help them over here. You gotta stop it though, please. Wait, don't do anything until I tell you to. Don't do anything until I tell you to. Okay, sift it. You gotta do it nice, Sophie. You lift it up just a little.
So no, good.
Yeah.
I want to.
See how it's all inside? You're going to tap it a little too. Okay, go ahead. And we're going to put more through. So move it over to the left, put it back down, because I'm going to put more in.
Let's make it fluffier. Okay.
So you're going to do the same thing right there. I'm going to try to fix your apron because mommy
forgot.
Can I
do it right here?
That's fine. Mommy forgot the blue aprons in school, or Mrs. Sauer forgot the blue apron. This time she remembered her camera clipper, but forgot the apron, so I had to go out and buy aprons. And fortunately, I chose the wrong color because black shows everything that we're using, right? The flour getting all over. Oh well. Timer telling us that our oven has been preheated. Okay, so now you have to measure 1 cup, 1/4 cup, so just wait a second, and then 3 tablespoons. So I'm going to give you another piece of wax paper. Just wait a second, please. You're gonna put the measure. No, 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 no. So that's what I tell the kids all the time. You need to lightly spoon and level off. So now you're gonna take, just let me show you and show the students. You're gonna lightly spoon into this cup and then you're gonna level off and you're gonna place it over there. So lightly spoon and level off. And while Jake does that, I'm gonna measure the baking soda. So baking soda is 11 and 8. You're not, you just made it nice and fluffy. You're not supposed to press it down like that, Jake.
Oh.
Okay, lightly spoon and level off.
Three of these?
No, one of those.
And
keep it over a little. Now take your leveler, level it off. Put that on
Wait, did I fill?
No, you're okay. Now put that on that piece of leftover. Do it nice because it'll get all over the place. Just do it quick and there you go. You're good. Okay. So that's one cup. Now you need to do a quarter cup.
Okay.
Just do it like that. You're okay. Just lightly spoon it now. Now I'm going to try to do the baking soda.
You mean try?
Like I was saying, I think I was saying, is that baking soda is a leavening agent. It's going to help these cookies rise. I'm going to do a quarter cup, and I'm going to measure, yes, a half teaspoon, and I'm going to need to take that leveler from you. But you actually need this, Jake. I thought I had another set of measuring. So I'm going to level off. So I have two pieces of wax paper here, so I need the leveler. Piece of wax paper. Now Jake, I'm going to get this back into the container. Now Jake is going to measure 3 tablespoons. Let's actually take it right off.
Biggest?
No, that's 1.5 tablespoons. So you're going to do this. So now you don't have to lightly spoon.
Okay.
So now you could do that 3 times and then you're going to level off and put it over there. So you did 1 cup. You have to level off though.
Okay.
Do it nice. Do it slow. Make sure nice and even. 1. What ingredient is after the baking soda? Can you read it after where it says baking soda? 1 teaspoon, can you read that?
1 teaspoon of baking soda.
We already said baking soda,
don't we? 1 teaspoon.
1 teaspoon.
Cream of tartar.
Tartar, cream of tartar. So this, we don't have a lot of, so I'm gonna have you pour it. I'm gonna pour it into the measuring cup. So cream of tartar is again another leavening agent. I believe you can substitute cream of tartar for baking powder, but I would look into that. I don't know the amounts and the equivalents to that off the top of my head. So cream of tartar, we got 1 teaspoon. Nope, that's 1/2 teaspoon. So we need 1 teaspoon of cream of tartar.
That's very small.
You never use thick amounts of this. So what you're going to do is you're going to slowly, how about you hold this and I pour?
No, I'll do it.
Okay, but I don't want you to pour all of it. So I'm going to do that. You're going to hold the spoon and you're going to level off.
I can do that.
You can, but I don't need it from another recipe. Okay, so now what you're going to do is level it off.
Wow.
But you see how you didn't get it all? We need to get a little bit more in there. So let's just add a little bit more. Now when you level it, come towards you. Now go back the other way. We'll do it again. Okay, and now we need a piece of wax paper. Here, you're going to put it on the piece of wax paper. So cream of tartar is pretty expensive. We only use this in a couple of different recipes. Here we go. Okay, you can't play with it though, Jake, because you're going to lose all the amount. And our cookies aren't going to come out. So who can we maybe give this cookie that we're making to in like 2 nights? Who's coming to town? Santa's coming to town, right?
I'm gonna give him it and hot chocolate.
And hot chocolate, you wanna leave him?
Yes.
Alright, and then we have a very small amount of salt. Now salt, I don't even have an eighth of a teaspoon, but we have a quarter of a teaspoon, so an eighth is actually half of this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do this by eye, and we can do this in class too. So can you hold that for Mommy or Mrs. Sauer? You could even just do a pinch if you want, but by eye, I'm gonna do about half. Do you think that's half of that?
No.
A little bit more?
Mm-hmm. Good.
Good, okay, now pop that on there. And then we're gonna see if we've measured out all the ingredients. That's basically everything. So we have a half cup of margarine, which is one stick, 3/4 cup of sugar, correct? 1 egg cracked, 1 1/4 cups plus 3 tablespoons sifted, perfect. Sift first, then lightly spoon and level off. A 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 teaspoon of cream of tartar, and 1/8 teaspoon of salt. We're good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now we're gonna go with our directions. So it says in a large bowl, I'm gonna do the large bowl, and you're gonna do the medium bowl. You wanna do the medium bowl, and I do the large bowl.
I'm medium.
Okay, so in a medium bowl, you're gonna combine. So in school, one person should be doing direction number one, and one person should be doing direction number two. So in a large bowl, it says mix together the margarine, the sugar, and the egg until spoon or butter. I'm going to put it in. Whoops. And you're doing the large, right?
I said medium.
You want to do the medium one? So you're just doing the flour, the sugar. You're doing the flour, the baking soda, the cream of tartar, and the salt. And I'm going to do the butter. Okay, so where is my wooden spoon? Uh-oh. Where's my wooden spoon? Actually, I have it over in the bag that I got from school.
Maybe we
should
use this?
Let me go get the spoon. There's the wooden spoon. Oh, that'll work, but I don't like that one. Put that one back. Put that one back, please. Gee, salad. Put that back. Okay, I'm going to do the margarine, the sugar, and the egg. Just wait a second, and then you're gonna put the other stuff in a bowl. And I'm gonna mix it together until it's nice and smooth. And you're going to put the flour. So you're just gonna stir this together lightly, Julie, because if you do it a lot, you're gonna lose everything, okay?
So what
uses
this and this?
That's what I thought. Can you just wait? Can you leave that there in front of me, please? Put that back. Bring this back. This. All the dry ingredients except your sugar. Okay, I'm gonna have to help you then.
No, I want to do this.
I know you want to do it, but I have to get it started. So what I want you to do is just take this spoon, very slowly stir it, or it'll go all over the place. And I'm just gonna get this started. So I'm gonna make sure in class that the butter and margarine that we're using is already nice and soft, so it'll cream together really, really well. All right, if it's too hard, it's gonna be hard for you guys to do this at school. If you're at home, you can use an electric mixer or a hand mixer, would make it much easier, but
okay,
at school, your hand is the mixer. Okay, so we're gonna switch gears. Yeah, your arm, you're using the wooden spoon. So what you need to do is get this all creamed together. Okay, so what I did earlier is I already made a batch of the dough. Let me just get that in there, so I can show you both days. Because with this dough, it does have to be chilled. It is pretty sticky after making it. So every cookie recipe we do in school will be a 2-day recipe. You'll make the dough one day, and then the next day you'll come in and bake, eat, and taste them the second day.
Are we gonna eat them today?
We can if you want.
I do.
You're gonna try a snickerdoodle?
Because
mm-hmm. Jake usually doesn't eat cookies that are made from scratch. He likes soft cookies. Right? He likes Oreos, right?
I'm watching myself.
He's watching himself stir. We're gonna, look, can I just check that? Because I don't wanna run out of. So what you wanna do, now we also forgot, what did Mommy also forget? Or Mrs. Sauer also forget?
The rubber scraper.
Right, because I like to use the rubber scraper at this point. So I think we're actually good. So now, our next direction says to add, stir the flour mixture into the cream mixture. You're gonna do that, but again, you gotta go really slow or else this flour is gonna go all over the place. Do it slow, do it really slow. Can I just get it started? And then let me just get Again, I like to go around the side. So this is gonna take some muscle too. So what I tell the kids in school is to kind of scrape it together.
You want me to do it?
Well, I'm just gonna get you started. And then they say, oh, it's not coming together. Well, again, just keep doing it nice and slow. Here, why don't you do it a minute? I'm gonna move some of this stuff away. Because we're gonna make the cookies and bake them too. I'm just gonna get rid of some of this. Show them how to roll them out properly. So this is gonna take some muscle. You're gonna scrape. If I had a rubber scraper, we would be scraping the side of the bowl. Just be careful this doesn't come up in your face. And it should actually come right around the side of the bowl as you mix. So let me try it again. So when I say rake it, it's kind of like you rake the leaves with Daddy.
Mm-hmm.
And I get all this. See how it all came together? Like a nice, kind of looks like sugar cookie dough too, right?
Mm-hmm.
I know you want to make them. So Jake wants to make the sugar cookie recipe too. Okay, so you see how all the dough is coming off the side of the bowl? Don't put those lights on because it's going to clutter. So this is basically done. So in school, what you're going to do, you're not going to take it in your hands. It's sticky. What you're going to do is you're just going to take your wooden spoon. If you have your rubber scraper, I'm going to actually just use my leveler. I'm going to use that to get it all off. And my assistant, Jake, can you go in our refrigerator and get the dough that's already made? So this has to chill. You can probably add a little bit of flour, but we don't want to toughen up the cookies. I always like to chill it.
Today?
Okay, so we just finished the dough. We ran out of storage. I'm hoping we're going to have enough room to continue with our demonstration. So this is the end of day one, all right? But we just took some dough out of the refrigerator.
Here's the dough! You want to see me throw it in the air?
Well, you see you throw you in the air? Are you serious, Jake? Come on. No, Jake. Stand up. Come on. You need to help me. Alright, so now what we're going to do is we're going to take little pieces of the dough. It's going to be cold because it was in the fridge. And you want it the shape of a walnut or the size of a gumball. Okay, so you're going to take a portion of the dough. So it's a molded cookie because you roll it into the shape of a gumball, a walnut way too big. So this is your demo, okay? So we're going to see, and then you're going to roll it. So I tend to do a demo cookie in school. That's the size, right? But before you put it on the tray, you're going to put it in the cinnamon and sugar mixture. So the one thing you really, perfect. You want to be careful about doing in school is when you put these in the oven, they can roll right off, all right? So you have to be very, very careful, or else your cookies are going to roll right off of the floor. So cookies are going to spread a little bit too, Jake, so you can't have them as close as you just put that. So we're going to put three across and then four down, all right? And we're going to keep rolling. Remember, you want it the same size, so look at that. Roll, 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 roll. So see how I roll it? Roll it in the palm of my hand. And everybody can do this in class, so then there's time, because you're going to see it's actually going to take a full period for these cookies, for you to roll them out, to bake them, and then for them to come out of the oven, and then you get to taste them before you go home. You could eat them in class, or you could take them home with you and share them with your family.
They
smell good, right?
I want the cookie dough.
You can't eat the cookie dough, because it's got raw egg, right? So good. Remember, you want to look at the demo cookie. They look like they're all pretty good sizes. I keep looking at my phone. It looks like I got a text message.
From Bubble.
Bubble. Who is Bubble?
Kara.
Aunt Kara. So he calls my sister Bubble. That's a long story, right?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. Right. Why we call her Bubble?
Oh,
do you remember why we call her Bubble?
No.
Well, at least she's part of our video now, right?
Mm-hmm.
She used to like bubbles all the time?
Yeah.
So she's doing bubbles.
But this. Good.
Good.
It's a big boy.
So we're going to do three more on this cookie sheet.
One, two, three.
And then I think I'm going to stop the video.
T- today.
Okay, no, so we just ran out of storage again for the third time, deleted a few things. So we got all, we got one tray of cookies rolled. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put them in the oven. We're gonna go about 5-6 minutes and then we're gonna switch and turn. I'm gonna stop the video and we're gonna come back. We're gonna roll the other tray and put them in the oven at the same time, right? Mm-hmm. And then we'll show when they come back out. Right, so we're
going
to go here. We're going to stop the video.
Thank you for watching.
We're not done yet. Okay, so quickly.
Ella!
So quickly, I want to show
Ella,
you.
Ella, boys and girls. Ella!
I thought we sent you in the bedroom. Ow! Okay, so when we're in school.
Ella!
Okay, so I have to show you, Jake. Move out of the way, please. When you roll your second batch of cookies, you may have a few extra cookies, and you're gonna say, "Well, where do I place them?" Jake, stop it. You're gonna place them in between these other cookies here. So I've ran out of storage three times. Jake,
four
times. Okay, and we're gonna go like this. So now we're gonna pop them in the oven, and then we're gonna show you what they look like when they come out. All right, so tell them what's happening. The timer's going off.
The timer is going off for the oven. Just trying to tell you they are almost done. Rudolph! Joshua is in! Ada! Oh my god.
Okay, so they're coming out of the oven. And you have to remember in school, too, you're not going to touch them. They are going to continue to bake on the cookie sheet. You want these cookies. Let me turn off my
like
timer.
This.
To stay nice and soft. So they're going to continue to cook for about 1 to 2 minutes. If I try to transfer them right now, they're probably going to fall apart while transferring them. Okay, so you always want to remember to have an oven mitt on. For me, my left hand, because when I go to take them off, the tray may move, all right? I'm going to give it a couple more seconds. Are you going to try one, Jake? It's a cinnamon sugar cookie. They're really, really good, but they're hot. Well, that one I ended up hitting, I think, with my oven mitt. And that tends to happen in school a lot, too. Just be careful. You want to make sure you don't burn yourself. So if you hit one of the cookies, you hit one of the cookies. It doesn't matter what they look like. It's what they taste like, right? Yes. Okay. So I'm going to go and I'm going to take a spatula.
Back to that. Can I do one?
I have a nice, simple spatula here. This works pretty good. But you don't, you have to hold. I'll hold this. I can't put this here because this wax paper is going to melt. They should come right off from all that butter too. You're gonna continue to do it. I have to bring it closer to you. Gotta get right up from underneath it. We just have to watch our time because we're gonna run out of storage again. So like I said, when we went over safety and sanitation, one of the biggest things people do is they tend to burn themselves, especially when we make cookies. Uh-oh. Here comes Daddy. Here he comes, Daddy. We're almost
come
done.
Come on, let's
Daddy.
Go.
Would you like to taste one of the cookies, Daddy?
I don't want
to
get on film. I don't want to.
Watch what you say, please.
Hello, mate.
Oh, Rudolph.
Yeah, I'll take one of these.
Whoa.
Oh, whoa.
Thank you.
Okay.